So in getting ready for a rubble pile search, there's a lot that goes into it because every opportunity is a training opportunity when we have these dogs out and working. So right now we're getting ready to place Alex, our canine care specialist, in the rubble so that he can help us with our training and make sure that Diesel, the search dog we're about to see, gets a full experience when it comes to his training and works on some of the challenges that he may be facing in his training to make sure he's in tip-top shape. And so Mandy is picking up a pallet here so we can better hide Alex and make sure that, number one, it's difficult for the dog maybe to find him and catch that scent, but it's also to hide him and keep Alex from being face-to-face with the dog right away. We want to make it a little bit challenging and a little more realistic. So over my shoulder, you can see up the canyon in a little ways our industrial park training prop, which includes a train wreck, a bus wreck. We even have an old airplane, a little two-seater airplane that's up there that the dogs can go ahead and search on and they can learn on, as well as a collapsed freeway prop, which would mimic a bridge or some other freeway that may have collapsed in an earthquake, especially here in California. So there are some vehicles that can be searched that just give a good variety of different training challenges for the dogs and handlers when they come out here. Now, the best part about our training props that are here is the idea every time a dog and handler come out to train, things will be different. We can change things up. Our training props are very flexible, so we can make sure that no team comes back and has the same experience twice. We want to make sure we continue their training, they continue to evolve and bond and grow as a team, and it's very, very important that we're able to do that. So both Industrial Park as well as our rubble piles here allow us to do just that. So I think we're just about ready to see Diesel come up here and search the rubble. So let's see how he does. He's a beautiful German Shepherd, and He is probably a mix. We don't always know necessarily what our dogs are completely. But he is a lean, mean searching machine, and he has a lot of fun up here on the rubble. So what we've done to set this particular problem up, in addition to hiding Alex properly, we've also checked the wind direction. And so we know that we want to send him from the direction that the wind is blowing into so that he can catch that scent and he can make sure that he's learning and can get into the scent cone, as we call it, as quickly as possible so that he can work with that search problem. So Katie's got him ready to go, and she's going to give him the command here in just a second. So you'll see he has no problem with his agility. He's going to be careful going over the pile, but he's not overly cautious. He's not afraid of it. He is going to cover the ground as quickly as possible because, remember, he's not looking for the victim. He's using his nose to find the scent of the victim, which is very different from how you and I would approach this pile. A lot of humans are using their eyes and looking for where a human may be, whereas he doesn't have to slow down to do that. He can very quickly cover it and say, nope, my nose knows, and it's not here, so I need to keep looking, and I need to use the wind to my advantage and see how much I can cover as quickly as possible. So he's going to check around the back of the pile. He hasn't caught the scent just yet, which is fairly typical depending on if the wind direction changes or if he just simply isn't in the right place yet at the right time. But you will see very quickly he'll come back around. He wants to check the entire pile, and oftentimes we'll notice a body language change as far as when he catches that scent. He's going to go almost directly to it because he knows it's there. And you see him checking. He knows that he's getting close, but this particular problem that we've set up is not as straightforward as what we would do for some of our newer search dogs on the rubble pile. This is more of a diffuse problem, which means the scent's coming out in many different ways, many different areas from where the victim is hidden. And so he really has to work through that. There he goes. Good boy. And he wants to make sure he pinpoints the strongest scent source. So he's not just alerting as soon as he catches the scent. He went in and he found where that strongest scent source is so that he can tell rescuers, in theory, on a real deployment, where they need to concentrate their resources. So after that strong bark alert, which is what everybody wants to hear when they're on an actual disaster deployment, the victim's going to go ahead and pop that toy out, and then he gets his reward. And it's so, so important that he stays right there with that victim, because it may take a handler a little bit of time to get over the rubble. We have two legs, and we don't have as good a balance as these dogs do, so we want to make sure they have that loyalty to the victim and they stay right there alerting as long as possible so that that handler can get there. Good boy, Diesel. So as I mentioned before, the dogs get to take their toys with them off the rubble pile, going back into their kennel. and they get to kind of think about what they've been doing, what they learned, what they covered, and really enjoy themselves and feel good about the job that they've done, which is the whole point, because he is a very good boy. Hi, buddy. You did so well. So it seemed like he did a really great job. What was he working on, and how do you think he did?
Sure. So he was working on a diffuse hide, and I think he did great. He really covered the pile well. You saw we kind of sent him from away. Maybe the wind might have been going, but it changes pretty quickly in the canyon here. So he had to kind of cover a lot of ground in a relatively quick time to catch the scent. And once he did, he was on it.
That's for sure. Well, thank you guys for letting us see you do a great search. You're a good boy. Good job, buddy. Go enjoy that toy. Awesome.